Do another one?
Yeah, what do you want to do next?
This is one I wrote with Brothers Osborne. Really cool, fantastic group. And it's called Nice Things. Well, God came down to earth to enjoy what she created. Took a fishing trip to Georgia to see what she could see. Cast out a whole little line and thought she'd hooked a big one. Reeled in an oil barrel and said, oh my me, this is why your whole world is on fire. This is why you can't drink from your own springs. This is why, this is why, this is why, this is why y'all can't have nice things. So she walked back to the highway, flagged down a passing stranger, an old man with a kind streak who offered her a toke. And just as she was partaking, the blue light started flashing. As he slipped the handcuffs on her, she thought this must be a joke. And this is why y'all are all strung out to Christmas. This is why I left you all them seeds. This is why, this is why, this is why, this is why y'all can't have nice things. So she walked out of the jail with a rap sheet and no money. Went looking for a coffee and passed by an angry mob. They were yelling about people who should suffer pain eternal. She asked one for a dollar and they said, sinner, get a job. And this is why.
This is why.
I blessed you with compassion. This is why.
This is why.
I gave you empathy. This is why.
This is why.
I said love your neighbor. This is why.
This is why.
Pills don't grow on trees. This is why.
This is why.
I gave you all salvation. This is why.
This is why.
Angels lose their wings. This is why, this is why, this is why. This is why y'all can't have nice things. Oh, this is why y'all can't have nice things.
Another new one from Hayes Carl and WNCW, Nice Things, from the new album coming out in a little bit. So you co-wrote that with Brothers Osborne. We know the Osborne brothers better than Brothers Osborne. It's because yeah. We're a bluegrass station.
I understand.
But heard about, all right, thumbs up. But we've heard of Brothers Osborne too. And you listed the guys in your band, Hayes, including Adam Landry there. And I know he's co-written a few songs with you as well.
He has. We had two songs on the last record and one song on this record, I think.
Three on the last one.
Three on the last one? Oh, that's right.
Quite a few on.
Yeah, three on the last one. And
from What It Is, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, super talented songwriter and producer.
Cool.
And a lot of folks around in this crew wear a lot of hats and have a lot of skills. I do one thing.
I don't know. You do a couple things anyway. well, it's good to surround yourself with good people.
Yeah.
Travis Linville here, we've heard of him. We've played a little bit of his music and such over the years.
Yep. He's opening the shows, I should mention.
Right on.
All the club dates on this run. And also fantastic songwriter and puts out a lot of records and does some production work as well.
Cool. And I guess Allison Moore, she produced some of this, or certainly did some, had a hand in some songwriting and inspiration.
She co-produced this record with Kenny Greenberg, a fantastic guitar player and producer. And she's this month, I have to go ahead and give her a plug. Her second book is coming out a week before my record. It's called A Dream He Talks to Me. It's
all right.
About her son, John Henry. And it's really powerful and beautiful. So if we got any readers out there, check it out, AllisonMoore.com. You can find that.
Cool. So a book tour, an album release tour. They could meld together or something.
Yeah, we're trying to trying to figure out how to see each other during this time.
You do great collaborations with various one-offs here and there that will show up. But you and Allison, of course, have been just a great pair musically and otherwise over the years. Really fed each other well, it sounds like. And Ray Wiley Hubbard, that was first we heard of you was you collaborating with Ray Wiley back in the day. How's he been lately? I haven't heard from him in a while.
He's good. It's such an inspiration. Ray's been a mentor to me and somebody that really is incredibly generous and helped me kind of navigate this life in entertainment and creativity. And he's going to turn 75 next month, I think the beginning of November, actually. I'm going to Austin to play his birthday party at the Paramount Theater. But 75, last year he signed a record deal. He put out a record on Big Machine Records, a major label, with Ringo Starr and Joe Walsh and Chris Robinson and the Cadillac, like all these different people. At 75, he's peaking. and it's incredible to watch and gives me hope, like for somebody that, he just kept at it. He stayed true to his craft and didn't change what he does for anybody. At a certain point, he said, this is what I'm going to do. And people came around to him. And I think his career is in a better place than it's ever been. It's really cool to watch. So he's doing quite well.
Cool. Yeah, he's doing something right. Yeah. He's got a cool autobiography. He's a good writer.
Yeah, a story well, read, I believe.
Yeah, so it's a good 30 years from now, but what do you see yourself wanting to do when you hit the big 75?
Oh boy, I don't know. I'm not sure I want to be out gigging, but we'll see. A lot of people have said that and find themselves in that situation either by choice or necessity. But I don't know. I hope I'm engaged, whatever it is. That's really all that matters. I don't have a dream other than to hopefully be content with whatever it is I'm doing.
I could see yourself getting into writing, the way you form these characters and allow us to just kind of get in their heads and hearts and empathize with them. You got a knack for that, and I don't know, maybe your wife can help you nudge you to become a good writer as well.
Yeah, I've got a good coach in-house. I'm not sure I have the attention span to write more than 3-minute pieces at a time, but we'll see.
Well, there are blissful 3 or 4 minutes when we hear a good Hayes Carl song.